Lace Up Crew merch is in the store finally with the new website, rjwattstv.club. From the shirts, hoodies, to the hats, the stickers, the face masks for the COVID-19 situations, you know the vibes, and of course the mugs. Make sure you check out the website, go cop. Also go on your phone, pull up the same site, rjwattstv.club, scroll through, let's get it lit. Cop the merch, send it to your boy, tag me on the picture, I'll put you in the merch gallery, man. Appreciate you guys with all the support. You dig? What's good, YouTube? This is your boy RJ back with another video for you guys. And yes, we are talking about NBA 2K21. Yeah, 2K20. We're not really going to be talking a lot about 2K20 anymore. But this is to start the process of talking about 2K21. Now, we do know all three of the covers from Dame Lillard, Zion, and of course the Mamba Legendary Edition Kobe. That is going to be dropping. Now, the biggest things it's been talks about is generations. When I say generation, next gen consoles, because we got to understand that buying one game, because the game is going to drop before the new console drops, that means is it going to convert over. Now, right here, what I have is a bunch of pre-order FAQ questions that we're going to go over. We're going to read what they're saying, and we're just going to talk over what's going on. So we're going to get right into it. But before we do that, make sure you guys hit the like button, subscribe, and you join Lace Up Crew. You know the vibes as always. And how you guys been? Comment down in the section below if you're ready for 2K21. You know what I'm saying? Even though hopefully it's not a replica of 2K20, you feel me? But out the gate, the first question, it says, when will I get my next gen copy of NBA 2K21 if I order the current gen NBA 2K21 Mamba Forever Edition? Now, like I said, that's been the biggest question of what's going to happen if I purchase it now and then I buy the console. So they say when you purchase the 2K21 Forever Edition for the PlayStation 4 or Xbox One physically, your next gen copy of 2K21 will be bundled in a code included in the box that contains all the additional content. So pretty much, if you go ahead and purchase it, they're going to give you a code from the receipt. Keep that code to the new console come out. So for those that, yeah, make sure you guys are organized, keep your goddamn receipts, because if you lose the receipt, I bet they probably won't get it to you again. So be careful with that. Next, it says, when will I get my current gen copy of 2K20 if I ordered the next gen 2K21 Forever Edition? So it says, when you purchase the Mamba Forever Edition on PS5 or Xbox Series X physically, your current gen of NBA 2K21 will be bundled in the code. So the same thing, they'll be bundled in the code, as well as in the first question. So it says, does this mean that if I buy a physical copy of 2K21 Mamba Edition for the 5 or the Xbox after the current gen launch on September 4th, I won't get my current gen copy until the next gen launches? It says, yes, as your current gen copy of 2K21 will be bundled in the box that contains all the additional content from the Mamba Forever Edition, you'll need to wait to receive the physical copy of the game. So that was pretty much for physical copies, for the ones that that definitely want the card, not to say the card art, but the artwork of the Mamba Forever Mamba Edition, which I might just cop because that's going to be legendary to have. Not to say that probably would be his last cover, but that is within 2020. Has been a rough year, so I would definitely say getting a physical copy would be beneficial. Of course, I'm gonna get the digital as well, but I'm gonna definitely go ahead and get that physical just to hang somewhere, because it's gonna be a nice frame for that. But for the digital copies now, when will I get my next gen copy of 2K21 if I ordered the current gen 2K21 Mamba Forever Edition? When you purchase it, you purchase the Mamba for the 4 or the Xbox digital, the digital copy of next gen version 2K will be added onto the same PlayStation or Xbox accounts. So I figured that was a question too. What if you get it digitally? Will it carry over to the next gen? I figured that would happen, because it's like, okay, if my game is connected to my Sony account, just like my game is connected to my Microsoft account, that should automatically transfer over. which that's pretty much what I was saying. Now I can't see what's the problem with doing that. So definitely, if you guys purchase it, it will automatically transfer over, so there's no need to worry. And this is from what the 2K website is saying. That was pretty much the majority of the questions that they were pretty much talking about. Now, it was other topic conversations of, will the My Career player transfer over to the next gen console? Now, I did see a clip from Ronnie. He did state that no, that it won't transfer over to the next gen console. So when he's saying that, that's sounding like it's going to be a whole different game on next gen. So the My Team, all that will transfer over, but the My Career won't. So now I'm kind of curious as to, all right, so are they looking into My Team? Are they looking into any other game mode, or they're just focusing on the storyline, the aspect, the graphics, the artwork behind the next gen console? So what do you guys think about that? I want to hear y'all thoughts in the comment section below, because that right there, but then again too, Ronnie, you know how Ronnie does. Ronnie just starts saying stuff what he wants to happen, but it ends up not happening. Like I said, Ronnie is not the developer, he's just a marketer in the face of the 2K Sports. So at the end of the day, Ronnie can try to make decisions on what he don't want to see, but same time, he can't make the game. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just curious how this game is going to be. Everybody's ready, excited. I'm not going to be pre-ordering anything. I might just go ahead and pre-order the digital one and get that out the way. But of course, it's kind of hard to pre-order something when you didn't see the graphics, and they kind of do that a lot. They don't pull out an intro. They gave us a teaser of Zion's face sweating and dunking, but that's not an intro. That's just, you know what I'm saying, let me just throw this out here. So at the end of the day, I want to see some live, not say some live gameplay, but give us a little intro with some graphics. You know what I'm saying? Madden does it. I can't see why 2K, you know, can't get that apart. I know they ready to get this money going, get their pre-orders up and running, but, you know, it's that time, man. 2K21 is almost around the corner, so it's time to get everything ready for the revamp. And when I say the revamp, the start over. Let's start over back to 2K21 and get it cracking, because 2K20 is at that. 2K20 is pretty much at 99% for me, and it's time to, let's go over 100% on board, and let's go ahead and throw that game away and get to 2K21 already. But you know, I just want to talk to you guys about what's been going on with 2K21, what I've been seeing with 2K21, hear y'all thoughts on with 2K21. And like I said before, let me know more topics you want me to talk about with upcoming 2K21. Do you want me to talk about in depth of defense? You want me to talk about in depth of what I want to see for offense, defense, plays, or, you know, anything in 2K21 that you guys want me to talk about? Let me know in the comment section below, because at the end of the day, I want to get this content out to you guys. It's that time again. It's that time. And we just need to come together and speak on these things, because their focus point is going to be mainly My Career. I talk about this a lot on posting the 2K20 content. I feel like me posting 2K20 content right now, is it at an all-time low? No, not really. But I just feel like me posting the same content for stuff that we're not really caring about or to care for, but I can't sit there and say that, because you guys may care for 2K20 content. Now I can do a little something different and make some content for you guys if you want me to. Now I'll definitely do that, probably, you know, get a little storyline going or something along the mix, because yeah, man, it's time to transition the ball game to something different. You know what I'm saying? Until 2K21 drops, you know the vibes as always. But like I said before, hey, also go make sure you check out the new merch store. Like I said, you know, we got the new merch store. Everything gonna be in the description below. My Twitch, Instagram, the merch store. If you cop, please, if you cop, let me know. Tag me in a picture when you do get your merch, or you drop, hey, you got a picture you in the merch, so I can put it in my merch photo gallery, because I want to have a gallery of you guys in the merch, you repping the merch, because it really means a lot to me. And you know, that'll be lit. I'll promote y'all and all that good stuff. So at the end of the day, I just want to say I appreciate all you guys. Like I said, like, subscribe, comment if you new. Don't forget, join the crew. You know the vibes as always. Catch you in the streams. Catch me on Twitter. But until next time, some more 2K21 content. We dropping. You did.